As we have previously discussed, we are looking forward to do something similar to this. This will require that we create a new thread every time that we need to use the database. Once the thread is done, it will be garbage collected. This process will be repeated many times. Not only that, but we may create race conditions if various threads run at the same time. To avoid all these problems, it would be nice if we could have all our database calls in the same thread. That will avoid creating a thread every time and will ensure that our calls are done sequentially. Here it is where executors come to play. According to the executors class documentation, an executor is an object that executes submitted runnable tasks. It is normally used instead of explicitly creating threads for each of a set of tasks. That sounds exactly what we need. I have added the AppExecutors class to our code. As you can see, this is a singleton, so we always use the same instance of a class. This class contains three executors. In our app, we will only use the disk.io executor. But I have included the other two to give you a deeper understanding on how they can be used. As you can see, the constructor receives the three executors as parameters in this order: disk.io, network.io, and main thread. The disk.io is a single thread executor. This ensures that our database transactions are done in order, so we do not have race conditions. The network.io executor is a pool of three threads. This allows us to run different network calls simultaneously while controlling the number of threads that we have. Finally, the main thread executor uses the main thread executor class, which essentially will post runnables using a handle associated with the main looper. When we are in an activity, we do not need this main thread executor because we can use the run on UI thread method. When we are in an activity, we do not need this main thread executor because we can use the run on UI thread method. When we are in a different class and we do not have the run on UI thread method, we can access the main thread using this last executor. As it is not obvious to imagine a situation where this could be required, I have left an example for you in the instruction notes below. As we are not allowing queries in the main thread anymore, let's use our brand new disk.io executor. First, we are adding tasks to our database in the onSaveButtonClick method at addTaskActivity. Here, we can get the instance of our app executors and access our disk.io executor to execute a new runnable that will contain our database logic. Finally, we will need to make our task entry variable final so it is visible from inside the run method. Now, we can move to our main activity. Here, we are loading all tasks in our onResume method. Again, we can get our disk.io executor via the AppExecutors instance and execute a new runnable that will query the database to retrieve a list of task entry objects. Once done, we will pass the list to the adapter via its setTasks method. Unfortunately, this last bit cannot be done from the thread in our disk.io executor. Because of that, we will need to wrap it inside a run on UI thread method call. Also, we will need to do our task final so it's visible inside the run method. Remember that we will be able to simplify this once we learn more about Android architecture components. So let's add a note about it here.